Hello there, humans. It's been a while. Today, we are going to be talking about how to give your Unity projects that film look. Apparently, the look of celluloid is rather pleasing to humans. Don't ask me why. It's not like digital is superior in every perceivable way. That was sarcastic. Analog movies can look like crap. More visible grain, softness, inaccurate colors, and vignetting are all examples of things that film technology is more prone to than digital, and we as a result associate this look with film. Not to mention the horrible 24 frames per second frame rate of film. Disgusting. But since it's what humans are accustomed to, it's what they want to see on the screen still. The good old days, right? Retro and vintage is in nowadays. Artists are always chasing that old school look. Just look at our cinema director tutorial intro. Sigh. Anyway, by nature, your Unity project is not going to look like film. No video game is, really. But many do try to emulate that look. The Last of Us is a good example of this. Look at that grainy, scratchy footage. Wow. It looks like film that somehow found its way onto the ground and under your foot before finally making it into the projector. Even modern titles like Grand Theft Auto V, Doom, and Uncharted 4 go through great lengths to accomplish that film look. I'm going to break down the film look into a few key components that you can very easily emulate in Unity one by one. These tips can apply to your in-game cameras or even your cinema director cutscenes. Let's get started. The first component we're looking at is film grain. Unity has a built-in shader which can help you accomplish this very easily. Luckily for you humans, adding film grain to your scene will instantly give it a bit of that organic feel. And since humans are organic, they like this aesthetic. Next, you have to color your shot like film. We actually have a free tool that can help you out with this. It's called Cinema Themes, and you can find it on the Asset Store. It's really easy to use. Just open up the theme browser, select from one of our many themes, and boom. A preset, filmic color curve, is then applied to your camera. Nice. Now let's talk about vignetting. Sometimes vignetting is an unintended side effect of having a lens that doesn't cover the format size you're shooting on. But sometimes it's a post-processing effect that can be exploited for dramatic effect. It's one of the ways you can make your Unity camera look a little less perfect. Just use it subtly, of course. Now, depth of field. In layman's terms, depth of field determines what is blurry and what isn't. You can play around with Unity's built-in depth of field image effect for great results. Go crazy. See if you can get your subject in focus and the background out of focus. To learn more about how depth of field works, I'd recommend grabbing a copy of Cinema Suite's Cinema Pro Cams. It's a camera toolkit that, among doing other things, helps visualize how depth of field works, expanding on Unity's built-in camera system quite a bit. It's a great learning tool for that. Grain, color, vignetting, depth of field. Follow these steps and your game will look considerably more filmic. And humans will probably like it more, because they prefer the look of a vastly inferior format over a nearly perfect one. Anyway, I'll catch you humans next time.